in this presentation. We are the first state in the country to implement this paradigm shift, both in letter and spirit, and under a sector-wide approach principle, the SWAP, which actually means that irrespective of source of finance, a uniform process is in place across the state and the sector. It covers the whole state. It is facilitated by the Department of Drinking Water, and the facilitating agencies within the government department are the Uttarakhand Pejal Nigam, the Jal Sansthan, and the PMB Swajal. The project budget $224 million for the sector-wide approach, of which the banks, the World Bank share is $120 million, and this ends June 2014. Aims to benefit 1.2 million people, which is about 20% of the rural population, and improve sanitation in about 30% of the rural communities to be declared ODF. Now, basically, what does it entail? PRIs, the local communities, they plan, they procure, they construct, operate, and maintain their rural water supply and sanitation facilities. We have the single village schemes and the multi-village schemes, and all the single village schemes and the intra-village multi-village schemes are the full responsibility of the user water sanitation subcommittees, which are a subcommittee of the Gram Panchayat. It is a legal entity. We have a government order for that. It was in the state through the Panchayati Raj Department. The bulk water supply, especially with regards to high-end pumping, that is, if you see the topography of the state, you have a vision here. We have a lot of river systems which are tapped for water where we don't have gravity sources or spring sources which can be tapped through gravity. So those mainly form the bulk water supply. And for that, up to the clear water reservoir or the limit of the village, the government agencies are involved for this kind of work. This is just the structure that we have. We have the district units and the district water and sanitation mission, which is headed by the chairperson of the Zilla Panchayat. And we have the Gram Panchayat committee and the user water sanitation subcommittee, which is headed by the Gram Pradhan itself. The fund flow mechanism is similar. Again, the fund flows to the GP from the district unit, and from the GP to the user water sanitation committee. And the beneficiary contributes to this fund also. Now, basically, this is the scheme cycle. It was given in a few slides, various other versions of this. This is what we follow. And it has four phases: the pre-planning, the planning, the implementation, and the O&M. Now, as you can see, about 3 months' time is spent in the pre-planning phase, wherein the facilitating agencies, they sit with the end users. And that is where all the data, baseline survey, all the data is generated. And the thought in the community or the demand that is to be generated within the community comes in from this. Obviously, water is an essential requirement. And in the state of Uttarakhand, you don't have to pursue too much to get a demand for water, because I keep getting letters from all the Gram Pradhans how they want a water supply scheme in their village. The most important part is the planning phase, which is a 6 months duration, and then the preparation of the plan takes place, following which the detailed project report is prepared. And now the most important part is the collection of all the community contribution is upfront. Capital account plus 1 year O&M account, and the communities have no problem paying it. Once this is done, it is reviewed by the District Water and Sanitation Committee, approved by the District Water and Sanitation Mission. Now, decentralization of powers, the District Water and Sanitation Mission is empowered to clear schemes up to the amount of 50 lakh. Now, that might not be a too big an amount for other states, especially in the plains, but in the hills, we have small gravity-based schemes. And 96% of all the schemes under this project are gravity-based, which means zero O&M cost as far as power is concerned. And a lot of schemes are generally cleared at the level of the district itself. We have this, the signing of the implementation phase quadruple agreement, sounds big, is just a legal agreement between the PRI, the UWSC, the district agency and the support organization, how we are going to move forward on this. The implementation phase, I'd like to inform you that all the schemes are insured. All the schemes in the implementation phase are insured, primarily because, again, the weather conditions and the topography of the state are a little difficult, especially during the monsoon, and we have a lot of heavy downpours, this can wash away schemes, and then it's difficult for the community to step up and contribute towards construction of the assets that were already created. So during this phase, all the schemes are insured, and we have managed to get money from the insurance companies for 89 of the schemes, the 93 schemes that we had applied so far. These are just processes, as I said, it entails all these activities where the quality control is there, we have the social audit committees, the user water sanitation subcommittee has 9 to 11 members, 30% for women, 20% for SCSTs, that is how it is. And before the implementation starts, the construction starts, a procurement subcommittee is formed, which is again a committee within the village. These include three people. None of these people are to be part of the UWSSC. They are people who are not part of the UWSSC. And again, at least one person out of these has to be a lady. Once this scheme is constructed, the funding is released in three installments. The first 40% that is checked, the third party quality checks are there, the account keeping is checked for the community. Now all the paperwork, the account keeping and the field work, this is checked by a third party. And for this, as I said, the most important part is the planning phase, wherein 6 months time is spent with the community, the hand-holding period, where they are taught or they are encouraged to learn all these aspects of bookkeeping, account keeping, and also maintenance of their schemes. The O&M phase is 4 months. The implementation phase differs with the size of the scheme. The O&M phase is 4 months period, wherein, again, the responsibility of the SO or the support organization is refresher training, hand-holding of in maintenance of accounts, establishment of the O&M system, like the fitters, day-to-day routine work, all the kit, the maintenance kit that is available with them. And the UWSSC is empowered to have its own bylaws for the individual scheme, which could be specific to a particular village. And they are to enforce that bylaws, which they do very strictly. Sanctioning of new connections, record keeping, O&M, etc. This is all part of it. After 4 months, there is a formal ceremony, which is like a small wedding ceremony, wherein which we call Atmarpan, which means that the water supply scheme that has been constructed is taken over by the community, which they have themselves constructed. The role of the government agency is just facilitation. Nowhere in the whole process do the government agencies build these schemes. They are not part of the procurement. The procurement is done by the village people themselves. They are not part of the construction per se, nowhere. It's done by the village people themselves. And they are trained for this activity for 6 months prior to the implementation. Basically, these are all, this chart just shows you what the things it entails. There's a clear-cut grievance redressal mechanism there. All transparency is ensured. There are clear-cut wall writings, wherein which gives details of all the bank accounts, the amount of money in it. It is updated all the time. We have social audit committees existing and they function. And the model bylaws exist for each UWSSC. And to begin with, the whole approach is integrated, where water and sanitation are not treated differently. So when we go into the village and the planning phase begins, you also take stock of the sanitation facilities available. Now there's no point going into a There's no point going into a village and talk about a drinking water scheme and talk about sanitation coverage where there's no water. So we have a very robust web-based monitoring system. If you go to this link, you will get all the details, including procurement details and contract details. So we have tried to maintain a very high level of transparency. Just this, just a slide, just to show you how at the end of this, how the community is empowered. All the works that are checked, the assets are inventorized, the entry is done in the Gram Panchayat register, and transfer of assets and tools, which leads to trouble-free O&M. What are the impacts? Building local capacities. And this is received with a high level of enthusiasm from all the PRIs. And by building the capacity of these institutions to design, implement and manage their own works, in addition to managing procurement, finances and accounting. Then eliminating layers of bureaucracy, decentralized to the it is done to the local communities, they have eliminated all these layers. Leakage of funds was talked about. And obviously the time and expenses involved for lodging complaints to the authorities. You can imagine a habitation in a far off place and he has to come to a district or to another place to lodge a complaint about his water supply scheme to the unit. Now that all that has gone. Again, there is a saving to the state exchequer. And basically the community has the following advantages. Lesser dependence on outsiders for their own water supply. Gram Swaraj, community pride, community control, reduction in coping cost, as well as more availability of household space due to elimination of storing water in large containers, elimination of travel time, etc., improving the mean time between failure due to better quality of repairs and strict control supervision by the community itself. Reduction in women's drudgery by about 2 to 3 hours per day, leading to a better quality of life. And this, I mean, in ideal circumstances, we all say that women can use this time for other income generating activities. I mean, let's leave it to them to decide whether they would like to use it for leisure, taking care of kids, etc. Thank you.